Okay, I'm looking at your profile. You left a lot of this stuff blank.
Okay, well, I haven't really been anywhere noteworthy or mentionable.
Have you done anything noteworthy, mentionable?
She's gonna blow! Go! Go!
God, you're noteworthy!
Hey, my man, you still there?
No, I just, like, zoned out for a second.
Oh, okay. Do you do that a lot?
Fantasy and daydreaming and imagination in the right balance are an important part of who we are. I mean, as a creative person, that's all we really have. You know, in the story, it's sort of, you know, Walter's imagination and his daydreams end up really fueling him and sending him off into taking a step into reality.
The ice, Jace, she moves like a woman.
Where have you been?
Testing the limits of the human spirit.
I'd like to climb your hair, test that out. Hey!
Hey!
How was your weekend?
I had an awesome weekend.
Do you think that as you have a career that is to some extent dependent on make-believe, does that make you more or less prone to daydreaming?
Well, it's part of what I do is sort of think about stuff, you know, in my head all the time. I mean, being an actor, you're doing that. You're constantly trying to, you know, create the world that you're in, you know, the situation that you're in and the circumstances and all that stuff. It's just, you know, you're in your head all the time with that. And as a director, that's, you know, you spend months and months visualizing and trying to think of how the movie's going to look and living in the world of the movie. And so it's really, it's literally what you do in making a film.
I don't know how much other people daydream, but I think that if you're a director or an actor, writer, musician, I mean, especially in the creative field, I think it's essential. Yeah, I think we have to. And I think that's why the character of Walter is so timeless, is because it's sort of a secret thing that we all do. We all sort of go to that other place and probably don't really talk about it that much.
How often do you go to that place?
More than I should. During the interview, if you just see me like staring like this, just snap your fingers, I'll come out of it.
We have ahead of us the privilege of publishing the very last issue of Life magazine. Jumping up and down the floor. And for the final issue, we just received a negative 25 from Sean O'Connell for the cover.
It seems to be a film with some nostalgia for old media, for old celluloid, for old print, for old-fashioned ways of meeting people. Is that something that you feel?
Sure. I guess, like, I'm an old guy who likes that stuff. I mean, I grew up with all those things, and I've seen the transition, you know, in our world, really, you know, from a more analog world to a digital age that we're in, that, you know, a lot of things get lost, and I miss those things. Experience media now has changed the way we connect with each other, because we're much more distracted. And I mean, I know I am, because I'm always looking at my phone, or I'm looking at a computer screen or television. Not as much video games, but you know, my kids do. And it's just, you know, it's changed our interaction, our human interaction. It's sort of buffered it more. And I think that's, you know, changed our attention spans. It's all been affected by that.
Even in the daydreaming aspect of it, you know, if we're waiting for a plane or if we're sitting somewhere, you know, instead of maybe just being forced to be with our thoughts, we can just go on our phones or text somebody or look something up. I do wonder sometimes what that part of our brain will be in a few years, because I think it's important to not really know what to think about sometimes and to have our imagination fill that space.
Life is about courage and going into the unknown.
Don't stay, don't stay, don't stay, don't stay, don't stay, don't stay.